This is my house! Don't wanna talk about the future.
Don't wanna talk about the things I've done. Venom?
Eddie, how do you like my dancing?
Oh my god, Venom. You're so hot.
OMG, Eddie. Get over here and kiss me. Venom.
This is amazing.
This video is sponsored by Historic Mail. Oh, you thought there wouldn't be a sponsor?
Oh, I don't think so.
So recently I went on vacation to Philadelphia with my family and got to check out historical sites from the 1700s. And you know what? It was pretty interesting to check out all this history, and for those of you that enjoy history, Historic Mail is the best service and gift for history buffs who love the lost art of letter writing. If you sign up for this service, every week a stamped envelope is delivered to your doorstep from a historical figure, like Ben Franklin or Thomas Edison, containing the original reproduction of a letter penned by this historical figure, supported by a document providing historical context and a typed version of the letter. You'll get to know about the fascinating inner lives of the greatest historical figures from the primary source itself. Their most popular pack is the American History Gift Pack that covers letters from 1776 with the founding of the Republic all the way to 1976 with the Cold War at its height. And to top it all off, Historic Mail also plants a tree with every order as a way to help preserve the woodlands and raise funds to support global afforestation efforts. So if you're interested, check out Historic Mail or get this as a gift for the history lover in your life. When you order, a digital gift certificate is given to you right away to give to your loved ones.
Wait, show me.
Oh, look, it's Walt Disney to President Nixon when he was vice president. And that's what the letter actually looked like.
That is so cool.
Just go to historicmail.com/browntable and get an additional 10% off by using discount code BROWNTABLE10. Before we get into Venom 2, let's talk about Venom 1. Venom was a movie I quite enjoyed. It definitely felt fresh in a strange way, but ultimately, it was a pretty average film. There wasn't enough in it to make it truly worthwhile, and it needed to be more focused. But when they announced Venom Let There Be Carnage, I still got super excited. Andy Serkis is directing, and the dude is knee-deep in films about CG characters. He's been a CG character. This dude knows what he's doing. I'm also assuming the crew will have seen the fan reaction from the first film and realized that they need to focus more on the silliness that made the first film watchable. And of course, it's Carnage. Dude is a super-powered serial killer, and that's frightening to imagine. Lastly, the movie's runtime is only 90 minutes, which in my opinion is rather short, but that can lead to a movie with quick pacing, which can most definitely be enjoyable. I went into this movie expecting something and got kinda what I wanted, but also stuff I didn't expect. The main thing that I realized as the movie went along is that the film is essentially a romantic comedy, straight up. Ant-Man and the Wasp? More like Mid-Man and the Mid. Sorry, I'll take any opportunity to bash that movie, I really don't like it.
I have spent a significant amount of time with one of these creatures up my ass.
What do you mean by that?
Anyway, funnily enough, the relationship portrayed in this film works a lot better than a lot of romantic dynamics in superhero movies. Because not only do Eddie and Venom love each other, but because they care so much about each other, they can also hurt each other.
You chose me? Buddy, I'm the only person that took you in when your friends kicked you off the planet Ming-Mong because you are a reject!
And at a point in the film, the two break up in this glorious, incredibly funny scene, and it's a blast to watch.
I'm sorry! I don't know what came over me, please. Let me fix it.
How about it?
So I can break it again!
So what we really wanted to achieve in the scene is a couple of lovers breaking up. It's reached that moment in time, and it's the classic scene that you get in many, many movies.
Venom literally says, "I'm out of the Eddie closet," in a rave, full of people that a part of society would call weird or odd. A place where Venom says he can belong. There, Venom is accepted and loved, and that's honestly all Venom is really looking for in this movie. Love. He wants Eddie to love him and appreciate him as much as he loves and appreciates Eddie. The film has surprisingly touching moments throughout it, and this, to me, is where the movie shines.
It was always going to be a kind of carnival, Day of the Damned, kind of, or Night of the Damned sort of festival, sort of with an LGBTQIA feel, and that really came from Kelly and Tom's you know, the material in the script.
The amount of growth from the first film is definitely noticeable. Their relationship has already been set from the first film, so now it's down to writer Kelly Marcel, along with Hardy and director Serkis, to figure out where they have to go from there. Venom and Eddie have been living together for a while, and they've kind of settled into this routine. And I love how the film establishes the characters and their relationships in the first act. We get to understand who the characters are, what they want, and their interactions are what lead the story forward.
I was lucky enough to be able to come in to take on this story after all of that heavy lifting work had been done on the setup of the characters. Now it's seeing that delicious kind of evolution of their relationship as a couple. They go through all of the ups and downs, the excitement of being with each other, the boredom of being with each other, the day-to-day nightmare of living with each other in a flat.
Do you know how Venom and Eddie are able to beat Carnage? With the power of love, bitch. Their emotional attachment to each other allows them to become the lethal protector to best Carnage and Cletus, and ultimately save the day. The movie's on some anime shit, man, I don't know. In general, Cletus Cassidy is a much better villain than whoever the heck the bad guy was in the first film. The symbiote was Riot, or whatever. I just call him Elon Musk with his big-ass spaceship. And Cassidy and his relationship with Shriek has a lot of time put into it. I just wish it had as much time put in as Venom and Eddie's relationship. And I do love that as their relationship is flourishing, Eddie and Venom's relationship is hit like rock bottom. It's so good. One of the best aspects of this film is its short runtime, which leads to the movie always being on the move, but that also leads to certain elements being unexplored or not fleshed out enough. Like, I never found myself caring enough for Mulligan, the dude that will eventually become Toxin. I wanted more of Cletus and Shriek's relationship, and Carnage's slowly growing distrust towards Shriek. In general, I wanted to see a little bit more of Eddie and Venom's relationship together. Just a little bit more, you know. I want more of, you know, Venom using Eddie's body to, like, draw stuff really quickly. Just more goofy stuff, like when Eddie's reading Cletus's letter, animation just pops out all around them. That was fantastic, and it was really funny and kind of corny, but it was so refreshing, you know? It's something so ridiculous that you don't really see too much, and I love that shit. I do think that there was a missed opportunity for Carnage to be like in the comics, where it's not that Cletus and Carnage are individuals, it's that Cletus is Carnage. They aren't separate entities. I think it's because Carnage is like fused to Cletus's blood. And I think it would have been cool to see a duo that's been wrestling with their relationship the entire movie go up against what one would call the perfect relationship, because technically it isn't one. I don't know how to explain it, I hope it makes sense. Either way, I like what we got. I had a good time, but I don't think the movie is that great personally. That being said, it was so refreshing, unique, and original that I'll give it a pass. It had good amounts of like newer superhero styled movies, but also the early 2000s style movies. It felt like the goofiness of a Raimi movie mixed in with like a random romantic comedy mixed in with like an MCU superhero movie. It was so weird and so jarring. It's like the entire movie is the lobster scene in Venom 1. That's me consuming this movie. That's actually me, and the lobster is Venom Let There Be Carnage. I think more movies, especially superhero movies, need to explore the concept of love and everything it entails. I think they always kind of skim through that. It's like, oh yeah, the superhero has a love interest, and in the end, you know, they get together. But like, what does that mean? It's never really fully explored, and I love how this movie really went at it. More superhero characters having relationship issues, please. More superhero characters in raves having a blast. More gayness in general, please. Venom 3 better have a scene with Venom railing Eddie, I swear to God. Also, Spider-Man's in this movie. Spider-Man. It seems like Eddie and Venom were transported to the MCU. I'm assuming during No Way Home, during Doctor Strange's bullshit. But at the same time, I don't think they'll actually appear in No Way Home. I think MCU characters will cross into Sony's films, but I don't think Sony characters will cross into MCU films, if that makes sense. But we'll see. Honestly, I'm always excited for superhero stuff, but I want that superhero stuff to be wacky and insane and just bonkers, dude. I'm kind of tired of like the more so formulaic movies. I just want movies to go crazy like this one did, and even though it wasn't that amazing, I definitely respect it for doing so. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching the video. I'll give Venom Let There Be Carnage a 7 out of 24 stars, a 4 out of 5 hearts, and definitely a good time, no water required. Whoa, 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 before you go, make sure to subscribe and check out Interstellar Ranger Commence, an animated series Browntable is making. Link in the description. Thank you so much, Ryan Blaze or Blaz, I have no idea, for this epic she drawing from Interstellar Ranger Commence.
Thank you so much for watching this video. We deeply appreciate it. If you haven't already, check out Couple Reacts. That's where that's where we...
Thank you so much for watching the video. If you haven't already, check out Nat and me on Couple Reacts. We have a couple of episodes out already. Just tell us what you think. Oh my god, Mauricio, I have completely lost my voice. And check out Interstellar Ranger Commence. Thanks again, patrons, for everything you do. We appreciate your support. And I deeply,
deeply
love you so much. And as always,
we hope you come back to the table.
I left you all long ago, and don't even think I know you. And you